Hello, and welcome to this presentation on upgrading a KVM host in Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager. In this video, you will learn to identify important items to consider when upgrading a KVM host, enable required Oracle Linux Yum repositories and install the repository configuration file on the KVM host, demonstrate upgrading a KVM host in the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager administration portal, disable the repositories after upgrading, and demonstrate changing the cluster and data center compatibility versions. Before upgrading, there are some items which must be given consideration. With migration enabled at the cluster level, the virtual machines automatically migrate to another host in the cluster. A cluster must contain more than one host before performing an upgrade, so consider upgrading hosts one at a time because one host must remain available to perform Storage Pool Manager or SPM tasks. When you upgrade a host, virtual machines are migrated to other hosts in the cluster. Therefore, clusters need sufficient memory reserve, otherwise a virtual machine migration can fail. Shutting down virtual machines before updating the host can reduce memory usage impact of virtual machine migration. You cannot migrate a virtual machine using a Virtual Graphics Processing Unit, or VGPU, to a different host. Virtual machines with VGPUs installed must be shut down before updating the host. The first thing we need to do is install the oracle-overt-release-el7 package on the host. If needed, enable the repository called ol7_latest for the latest Oracle Linux packages and then install the package. Here the command yum repo list enabled ol7_latest is used to check if the repository is already enabled. Next, the command yum install oracle-overt-release-el7 installs the required package. During the installation, the repository file is copied into the /etc/yum.repos.d directory, and the required ol7_x86_64_overt43 and ol7_x86_64_overt43_extras repositories are enabled. These two repositories provide access to the latest release of the software used to upgrade the KVM host. Now we can look at upgrading the KVM host from release version 4.2 to 4.3. After a successful upgrade, we disable the overt-4.2 and overt-4.2-extra repositories. Disabling the repositories ensures that any future or intermediate upgrades of KVM hosts use the current release. The screen capture on the slide shows a sequence of commands to illustrate disabling the overt-4.2 repositories. The command yum repo list enabled *overt* lists all overt enabled repositories. The output shows both the overt 4.2 and overt 4.3 repositories are enabled. To disable the overt 4.2 repositories, use the command yum-config-manager-disable overt-4.2. In this video, we will upgrade the KVM host OVS025. If this were a production environment, we would perform these steps on each host. We are viewing the hosts pane in the administration portal. We select the OVS025 host from the list in the table. Then we click the installation button and select check for upgrade from the drop-down menu. This opens an upgrade host confirmation dialog window. We click OK to initiate the check process, with the manager host checking the KVM host to see if it requires an upgrade. To monitor the checking process, click the Events button, the bell icon in the title bar of the Administration Portal window. In the Events List dialog, we can monitor the progress. The first event shows that the check has begun. Soon after, the check for updates process finishes, indicating successful completion, and indicates a list of packages to update. And the host is then reactivated. We click the Events button again to close the list. To proceed with the upgrade, we click the Installation drop-down button and select Upgrade. From the Upgrade Host window, we will keep the Reboot Host After Upgrade selected. The dialog states there are VMs running which will be automatically migrated. We click OK to begin the upgrade process. Returning to the Events view, we can monitor the upgrade process. The host is first switched to maintenance mode, followed by the migration of any VMs running on the host. We also get notifications on the migration status. The next events we see are notifications that the restarting of the host has begun. The host reboots, and after some time, the triangle icon next to the host turns red. With a final notification that the host is active and running, the triangle is now green. After closing the event's messages, the icon indicating an upgrade for our host is cleared. We can see the other host, OVS018, has the upgrade icon showing, so if we wanted to upgrade this host also, we would follow the same steps. Our next demonstration will cover the post-upgrade task of switching the compatibility versions of the cluster and data center. Cluster compatibility version indicates the features of the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager supported by all the hosts in the cluster. For more information on the compatibility versions, refer to the post-upgrade data center and cluster compatibility versions section of the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager Getting Started guide. All of our hosts will run release version 4.3, so we will change the cluster compatibility to 4.3 to support the 4.3 features and to ensure that we do not have any issues. In the administration portal, go to Compute and click Clusters. Select the cluster to change and click Edit. We only have one cluster, the default cluster, so this is the one we'll use. From the Edit Cluster dialog box, we select the General tab. From the Compatibility Version dropdown, we select 4.3 and click OK. We select 4.3 to match the release version we upgraded the host to. On the Change Cluster Compatibility Version confirmation window, we click OK. Now we need to change the compatibility version of the data center. To do this, we navigate to Compute and then Data Centers. Click on the data center row in the table to be changed and click Edit. From the Edit Data Center dialog box, change the compatibility version drop-down to the desired value, 4.3 in our case, and click OK. On the Change Data Center compatibility version confirmation window, it warns us that making this change may affect any storage domains associated with the data center. These need to be upgraded to the same version also. We click OK. A pop-up message tells us the editing is complete. We have now upgraded the compatibility version of the data center. In this video, you learn to identify important items to consider when upgrading a KVM host. Enable the required Oracle Linux Yum repositories and install the repository configuration file on the KVM host. Demonstrate upgrading a KVM host in the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager Administration Portal, then disable the repositories after upgrading and demonstrate changing the cluster and data center compatibility versions. Look to the links provided here to access a vast number of resources that you can use to discover more about this subject and others in the Oracle Linux Learning Library. That's the end of the video. Thanks for watching.